in front of our Creator and everyone here. I am making this vow to do everything I can for us to have a happy family and life, for better or for worse. I will give my best for us to have a happy home. I promise to love you and take care of you every moment that we're together.
What's happening?
They discovered that the cargo to be shipped to America contained drugs.
Don't worry, we'll get through this. Let's help each other.
Daddy? No, Daddy!
What's wrong? Are you okay?
Mommy, there's a monster, and I don't even have a daddy who will save me.
Maybe it was just a bad dream, okay?
Mommy, where's my daddy?
You're leaving?
Love, I'll just give it a shot. Who knows, this could be the answer to all our problems. The starting salary is 30,000.
I thought we'd never be apart no matter what happens.
Did you like it?
Mm-hmm. And for that, I'm going to give you a prize. What do you want?
A pony.
Okay, Mommy will find you a pony. My love, where's the application that I showed you yesterday?
You won't be able to use it.
But I thought we already had an agreement. This is for our...
I sent it already. Don't you worry about it.
Marcus, come here. Marcus? Help me, please. Somebody help me. Please help me. Please help my son. For sale? Can you deliver them?
Sorry, I don't...
You better ride a bus. I'm Janine Arguello. The address of the farm is there. Love blooms. Wow, your wife looks so simple, but she's very pretty. And your son looks like a good kid, too.
My wife raised him very well.
And it seems you're both still very much in love.
I talked to the agency. They're asking me to come next week.
I can't imagine my life without you, my love.
I don't like to play with her.
Play with me, please.
My mom said she doesn't have a dad.
I have a father.
Liars go to hell. You don't have a dad.
I have a daddy. I have a daddy.
Your daddy left you because he doesn't love you anymore.
But my daddy loves me.
Are you sure? Why isn't he with you?
He loves me. My daddy loves me.
Audrey?
Mommy?
Stop that. Don't talk to her like that. I'm going to talk to your parents about what you've done. I'll tell the principal so this won't happen again.
Let's go. Come on.
Are you okay?
Why are they doing that to me? Is it true?
No, baby, it's not true. Don't believe them, okay? Your daddy loves you so much. And mommy loves you very much too, okay? Stop crying.
I heard from the grapevine that your ex Dale is back in Manila. How about you go and see him for Archie's sake?
How nice. You're very good in drawing, Audrey. Now, can you tell me about these images that you've been dreaming about?
In my dreams, I'm always walking alone. And then, a big monster would appear. Like that. And then, the monster would chase me. Then I'll run away from it. And while I'm running away, I always end up crashing into a big tornado. It's so strong, and I would move like this.
And then?
I would call out Daddy. I'll shout, Daddy, Daddy, Daddy.
And did your papa come?
Sometimes, but not always. And then, I couldn't always see Daddy's face. But he would always fight the monster. Like, yeah.
Why do you call out to him?
I can't ask help from my mommy. Because mommy's too small to fight the monster. And the monster might hurt mommy. I can't let that happen. If mommy gets hurt, what will happen to me?
And you believe your papa will protect you?
Yes. Because that's how daddies are, right? They protect their children. While mommies give love and care.
What if your papa doesn't appear in your dreams? How will you feel about that?
I will feel sad. But I know that my daddy will come. Because that's what mommy always tells me. He's working in a far, far place. But daddy will come for me. Right, mommy? Mm-hmm.
I didn't think you'd be here already. I don't want to keep your hopes up, Janine. He's not with me. And if you want to know, he's happy living in America.
Aunt Sandy, I just really need to talk to Dale. What's this for?
That's for my family's peace of mind. Let's not waste each other's time, Jenny. I don't like you. You know that. Please stay out of my son's life.
I won't cause any trouble. I just have something important to tell him. We have a daughter. Her name is Audrey. And she really needs to know her father.
With your mother's reputation, are you sure she's my son's daughter? For all I know, you've been sleeping with different men.
Please don't judge me. I'm a decent woman, and don't involve my mother in this issue.
Whether you like it or not, your mother's involved. Didn't she raise you by having affairs with different men, Janine? You don't belong in my family. And you will never get a taste of any letter in my surname. My son is not the father of your child. So if I were you, accept the check. That should be enough for you and your daughter to live on for the rest of your lives without us.
Aunt, I don't need your money.
To be honest with you, that Dale's got no balls. And he's such a mama's boy. Just forget about him.
According to the guidance counselor, Audrey needs a father figure. I don't know anyone who can fulfill that.
There are so many guys. Go on a date with them. You can date your gardener. You can even date this tricycle driver that I know. Go!
I just don't want to get hurt again.
Listen, Janine. You are such a beautiful woman. So make use of your beauty before it's gone.
Honestly, I just need somebody I can trust. I'm tired of relationships.
Love? Can you fix this for me? If you have it repaired, maybe we can still use it.
I'll take care of it. What will you do?
I don't know yet, but if we get that fixed, I think we can still use it. Have you dropped by the agency?
Yes, I did. I already took a medical exam. After everything's been processed, I'll pay a placement fee. $70,000.
$70,000? Where will we get that much money?
I'll find a way. Don't worry.
Yes! Yes!
Hello, Mom.
Hello, Tess. Have you picked up Audrey from school?
Audrey's here at home already, but she wants to go to the farm.
Well, she said she really misses you.
But I have a client call with Carla today. Listen, just don't stay too long in the farm, okay? Audrey might have another asthma attack. Last time she stayed in the farm, her allergies got really bad.
Okay, Mom, I'll remind Audrey about it.
Thanks.
Audrey? Well, your mama told me we should go home now.
Let's go home later. Look, I just reached level 8.
You're playing video games again. All right, I'll give you 15 minutes. I will stay in the farm for a while. Then we'll leave when I get back. Understand?
Okay.
Just stay here. Okay. Don't go anywhere. Remember, just 15 minutes, okay?
Really, you're going to lend me 70,000 pesos?
Yes, but we'll count this as salary deduction. Didn't you tell me that this is for Victor's placement fee?
Yes, you're right. Thank you very much. I'm so grateful. Don't worry, I'll make it up to you.
Yvonne, don't mention it. It's just 70,000 pesos. It's not like I'm lending you millions of pesos.
Yes, I know that, but this really means a lot to me. You know?
It's fine.
Just thinking about the fact that Victor's leaving makes me sad. When I think of Victor working in Dubai, I feel like I'm going to die without him.
It's okay, Yvonne. You're just doing this for your family.
If Victor and I were rich, we wouldn't have this problem. I'm serious.
There! Achoo! There, there! Come on, come on!
Hey! Are you okay? What's your name? Help me! Help me! Help!
Audrey!
Do you have a medicine?
Audrey! Excuse me, sir. Oh, dear. Hold on. Audrey, just calm down, okay? Now open your mouth. Her inhaler's not working.
Let's bring her to the hospital.
Wait, I'm going for help.
Are you okay?
What's happening?
Can we borrow a car?
I'm sorry. They're all out.
Oh, dear. Let's bring her to the hospital.
I'll carry her. Let's go.
Wait,
come on,
what's wrong with Audrey?
Sir, we need to hurry up.
Hello?
Hello, Mom! Mom, we're rushing Audrey to the hospital right now.
What? Okay, don't worry. I'll be there right away.
Stop! Stop!
Stop! Please stop. Help us! Hey! Hey, stop!
It's Mom! Hey. It's Mom Janine's car!
Hurry!
It's Mom! Hurry
up!
Mom, please hurry up! Audrey couldn't breathe, Mom!
Audrey!
We really need to hurry up!
We need help!
Please help
Doctor.
Us!
She can't breathe!
Please help us!
Doctor.
We need a doctor!
We have an emergency!
Just lay outside. Her down.
Baby.
We'll take it from here.
Please take care of her.
She's safe with us now.
Please save my daughter. Audrey is all I have.
How is she?
She's fine now. She ate sunflower seeds earlier in school from one of her classmates. She didn't know that she's allergic to them.
Audrey should have a list of foods that she couldn't eat.
She already has one, but you see, there's always a first time for everything that's not on that list. Thank you.
I have to go. My family is waiting for me.
Hold on. You carried Audrey from the farm to the main road. If you hadn't done that, I could have lost my only daughter. I owe you for saving her life. Thank you very much.
If you were in my shoes, you'd do the same thing, right? By the way, I'll come to work tomorrow afternoon. Besides, the barn's almost finished.
Are you sure about that?
I need to earn more money for my placement fee.
How much?
70,000. Please don't think that I'm asking you for a loan.
Of course not. Don't say that. To be honest with you, even though you saved Audrey, that's still a lot of money. Well, if you start working abroad, how much will you earn working in Dubai?
30,000.
Actually, I'm willing to pay you $30,000 every month. Just don't leave me.
So you will pay me $30,000 just to be your carpenter?
No. I'm going to pay you to be my child's father.
Do you really want me to be Audrey's father?
Yes, I do. I'll introduce you to Audrey as her father, who came back from America because you missed your daughter very much. Is that okay?
Why me?
Why not? You have nothing to be afraid of. I know you're married, you have your own family, and it's not as if I'm going to steal you or eventually make you take responsibility of my daughter.
You will lie to your daughter?
Look, this isn't easy for me either, okay? But you're a parent. Just like me. And I hope you understand that I'm only doing this for my daughter. It would mean so much to her if you would just accept my offer. She's going to be happier and more emotionally stable. All our insecurities will be gone. You don't have to worry about anything. You can keep yourself busy working in the farm. You can make papier-mâché for my flower pots, vases, and jars. They're for export. Please, Victor. I really need you to accept my offer. And if you think that I'm being desperate, I don't care about that. I just don't want to see my child suffer again. I love Audrey so much. I'll do anything to make her happy. Baby?
Where is Daddy?
Daddy?
Oh, was I just dreaming, Mommy? I thought I saw you with him earlier.
Really?
You were even embracing him. So I really thought he was my daddy.
Take this. I can't stop you from leaving anyway.
Listen. I haven't even left the house, so don't cry like that, okay?
I don't know what to do anymore. Yes, we need the money, but do you really need to leave your family, Victor?
We don't have enough money to pay for our bank loan. What do you think?
I don't know.
Mark has played all day in the field again.
Was looking for you all day. Your son missed you so much. What's keeping you from accepting my offer?
When you introduce me as her father, does that mean it's forever?
Forever? That's going too far.
Are you sure? You'll just tell her one day that I'm not her real father.
Well, I don't know. We'll cross that bridge when we get there. Even just 1 year is okay with me. And you will never have a responsibility or an obligation to me and Audrey. And if you want, I'm going to draft a contract that's for our mutual protection. That you did not force me, and I did not force you, and that this is all my idea.
That would be better.
So is it a yes?
Yes.
Oh, that's great, Victor. Thank you so much. You just have no idea how much this means to me as a mother.
I'm doing this for the money. And now, I don't even have to work abroad and leave my family. Last night, I watched over my son. I remember what happened to Audrey. And if the same thing happens to my son, I want to be the first to take care of him. I want to be there for him when he needs me.
Okay. So, business partners? Audrey's birthday is coming up. Is the barn ready? Wow. I am so impressed. Audrey will love this.
It's a good thing Marcus fell asleep instead of getting a tummy ache. He really enjoyed all the food you brought home. And you gave him a lot of presents. Was business good today?
No, actually, I just got a job at a flower farm.
A flower farm?
Yes, I'll be making paper mache for all the flower vases, jars, and the pots that will be exported. The good thing is, I'll get paid the same amount that I'll earn from working abroad. I won't have to leave you anymore. It's still 30,000.
30,000? That's a lot of money.
You could say I got lucky, and I'll be the one in charge.
That's a really big help to us, you know? Paying off all our debts will finally get easier. But what about your old job as a teacher?
I just resigned there. I can always reapply. What matters now is that I have a job that pays well.
You're right. At this point, we need to be practical.
Love, have you heard about a father for hire?
What's that? A new movie?
No. You see, my friend has a cousin. A rich lady hired him to be a father to her only daughter.
What kind of joke is that?
I wasn't joking.
You know, that's just ridiculous. I've heard of things like Wanted Perfect Mother or Bride for Rent, but those are just movies, right? Honestly, I think your friend's cousin just fell victim to a scam. He got fooled. Sit down, I'll dry your hair.
What if it's true?
Well, if that's true, then I will feel sorry for the wife or girlfriend of your friend's cousin, right? What if the rich lady falls in love with your friend's cousin, right? And what about the kid? Honestly, they will only be hurting that kid in the long run, you know? If that was you, trust me, I will keep a close watch on you. And if you fall in love with her, I will beat you up so bad. Okay? Come here. You smell so good. You really need to rest. I'll prepare packed lunches for you and Marcus. Don't wait for me, okay? Good night. Go to sleep.
Baby, are you enjoying your party? Look, so many of your friends came to see you. Isn't it fun?
I'll be happy if I see the one I've been praying for. Mommy, do you think Daddy will come?
I hope so.
This is for you.
Hello, Carla.
Hello, Hanin.
I'm here with Victor right now. But we have a really big problem.
Carla? Why? What's the problem?
There. Look at him. Look at him.
Please don't tell me you're backing out of the deal.
It's not like that. Relax. Look at him. Do you see what the problem is? Does he look like he came from America?
Is that the big problem, Carla? Don't worry.
I thought of that.
Here. Get changed. And please hurry up. Your kid's waiting for you.
You prepared for this, Janine.
Do I look good?
That's more like it. That's perfect.
Victor, you know what to do, okay? Good luck.
I have to say, he looks really handsome. Why are you blushing?
I put some blush on.
Where can I buy a blusher like that? Just tell me. It looks good on you. Janine!
Mommy, where are we going now?
You'll see. Be careful, okay?
Where are we going, Mommy?
We're almost there. Turn left, okay? Ready? Surprise!
Wow! This is so nice! Wow, a pink pony! Wow! There's a butterfly, too! Thank you, Mommy!
You're welcome. And I didn't just get you one pony, but look, I got you a whole barn. That's how much I love you.
Too bad they're all fake, baby girl.
But this is better than the real thing. It's so nice.
Really? Okay.
Do you like it?
Yes. Who made this barn? It's so awesome.
I did.
Audrey, meet Victor. He is your daddy.
Daddy? Where have you been? What took you so long to come back? Why don't I have pictures of you? Where were you when I was a baby? Did you miss me? Are you leaving again soon? Where will you stay? Will you spend the night in our house?
Audrey, take it easy on him.
That's right, dear.
Baby Audrey, don't worry about it. Your mommy will answer all your questions.
But why mommy?
Because all of this is her idea.
Come on, baby, make a wish now.
I don't have a wish. It's already been granted.
Boom! Hooray! Happy birthday, Audrey!
Come here. Happy birthday.
Can I get a kiss?
Victor, that went really well. I didn't know you were a good actor. Here's a copy of our agreement. Please read it carefully before giving it back tomorrow.
You're so serious.
I'm taking this seriously because I'm doing this for my daughter. All the do's and don'ts are in there. If there's anything you disagree with, just let me know so we can revise it. That contract is going to cover an entire year. Number one, be punctual. Audrey wakes up at 8 a.m. and goes to bed at exactly 9 p.m.
Please arrive before she wakes up and leave only when she's asleep.
We have to make her believe that you live here, and that we're partners in the farm. You will earn a commission from export sales of our papier-mâché products. Number two, your days off will be Saturday and Sunday. If Audrey demands that you join us on weekends, it will mean overtime pay. Of course, I don't want to make you feel that I'm wasting your time. Number three, don't tell anyone about this. As Audrey's biological mother, I am the only person who can tell her the truth. Number four, if Audrey asks you anything about your personal life, refer Audrey to me. Number five, you will get paid on the 30th of the month. Or do you want it on the 15th and the 30th?
Either way, it's fine with me.
Okay, number six.
Are you not done yet? I will just read the rest at home. It's getting late now. I have to go.
Just be here before she wakes up, okay? Victor, I would like to thank you again for making Audrey very, very happy today.
Victor, am I right? Mom Janina's been waiting for you. She's there.
Thank you. Good morning.
You're late.
Sorry. Dear,
I didn't know you slept here.
Yes. I didn't want to wake you up.
That's too bad. You should have woke me up. I really wanted to play with you. Please don't leave today, okay? I want us to play all day.
Of course. We'll play all day. The moment the princess began to stir, she sat up and rubbed her eyes. She's asleep.
Thank you. Good night.
I'll go ahead.
Thank you. Good night.
night, Audrey.
Who's Audrey?
What?
You said good night, Audrey.
She's my boss's daughter. She's only 6 years old. She followed me the whole day. She even checked out my cell phone. Kids these days are so annoying.
Are you sure? Audrey, I wonder who she is. Whoever you are, I'm going to beat you up.
Hello?
Hello?
Who is this?
Hello, I just want to talk to Audrey.
That's me.
Come on, don't try to fool me. I really want to talk to Audrey.
But I'm Audrey. Who is this?
How old are you?
I'm 7 years old.
What? Okay. Goodbye.
Why?
Nothing.
It's too early for that. Why are you so excited all of a sudden?
Whatever.
What is it?
Nothing. I just want you to know that I love you very much.
Maybe you're just hungry.
You're right. I haven't even cooked breakfast yet.
Then why are you acting so strange?
I will cook breakfast for you, and you're going to love it. Okay?
All right. Give me that.
It's a really good thing we got our van repaired, right? Think about it. We can use this as your delivery van at work, or maybe a school service. And I'm glad you're not working overtime today.
My dear, it's Sunday. Sunday is family day. Wait a minute. What are you thinking?
Nothing. But given your new job, it's like you still went to Dubai. We hardly spend time with your father anymore, right?
Yes, Mother.
This is much better than Dubai. We still spend time together on weekends.
You're right. And you didn't have to leave. By the way, what happened to your friend's cousin anyway?
I haven't talked to him again. Wait a minute. Why are you so curious about him?
Nothing. Don't worry about it. I was just asking you.
Where are we going today, Mother?
We'll eat out and go sightseeing. You like that?
Yes! Hooray!
Mommy, can I call Daddy?
No. Didn't he tell you? When your papa is at work, you're not allowed to call him. He works on weekends, right?
I want to talk to Daddy.
I said no. Baby, haven't we talked about this before? Baby, please don't bother Daddy while he's at work, okay? Because when he has problems at work, he might leave us again. Do you want that? Come here.
You know what? No one can be completely happy. I remember you felt sad because you thought your husband had to work abroad. because you needed money. But even now that you're more financially stable, and your husband is working here in the country, well, you still feel sad.
I don't know. I guess you just become more possessive when you really love someone.
Really? Why? You think he's cheating on you?
Not really. I'm glad that he's always been very honest with me. Besides, I know my husband well. He's not a womanizer. He's a decent man, and I know that he loves me and Marcus.
There you go. Well, what are you so worried about?
I'm just not used to him being away. When we got married, Victor would always find the time to spend with us. But now, we can only spend time with Victor during weekends. You know, he comes home late and then he leaves very early for work.
Well, at least he's not working abroad. You know what? There's no reason for you to be jealous, okay? Jealousy can destroy relationships. And if I were you, I'd follow him to work.
Follow him?
Yes, follow him. Hey, don't let him see you, okay? Because men don't like it when women start accusing them of cheating, especially when they're at work.
Well, I won't do that. I don't want to fight with him.
That's why you shouldn't let him see you, okay? You're only doing this for your peace of mind, Yvonne. If he's not cheating, then that's good. He's okay. See? Come on, just follow him.
Hello, Janine. I might be late today. I'm being followed by my wife.
What? Why?
I don't know yet, but she still doesn't know about you and Audrey. All she knows is that I work in a flower farm, so I'll go straight there.
Okay, sure. You can wait for Audrey there. Just don't come to my house today.
Okay.
Bye.
Stop. Thanks. Hello, love?
Love, where are you? You forgot your packed lunch.
I just got off the bus. I'm here at the flower farm. My boss asked me to go straight here.
Is that so? All right, never mind. Just be home early.
I will. Take care of yourself.
Okay, thanks.
Don't tire yourself out.
Okay.
Bye.
Okay, goodbye, love.
Hello, Nina?
Yes.
I'm following him right now. Wait a minute.
Oh, yes. It's confirmed.
Yes. My husband really works in a flower farm. Yes, in the Love Blooms farm. See? I told you. I'll call you later. Bye.
Daddy!
Hello there. How are you?
Daddy, could you teach me how to make toy horses?
I'd love to, but you know what? It's messy here.
No, it's okay. We'll just clean this mess. I know it's your passion.
Well, let's do it. Let's make some horses.
Thank you.
family used to sell handicrafts. But then, when my father left us, my mother and siblings decided to close it down. But me, I still love it.
You don't just love doing it. You're very talented. As for me, I became interested in flowers because of my mom. When she passed away, I started dreaming of putting up my own flower farm. At first, I didn't have a lot of money, but I worked really hard to make my business grow. Now, I'm very proud of my business. It's a good thing that my farm keeps me busy. At least I don't have to think about how terrible her father is.
What happened to him? Where is he?
Dale was my first serious boyfriend. Our relationship lasted 5 years. We were even supposed to get married. But his family got involved in a scandal. Something to do with plunder. So they had to migrate to the States. He couldn't leave his mom alone. He's a mama's boy. So eventually, we broke up.
Did he know that you were pregnant when he left?
He didn't. I didn't tell him.
But he needs to know. That's his right.
And then what? He'll stay just because I was pregnant? I don't want that kind of love. That will make him stay because of a responsibility or an obligation. I don't want him to stay because of a broken promise. I don't want that. I want him to stay because he loves me. Period.
You were together for 5 years and you don't think that he loved you?
Well, we loved each other, but I know he loves his family more. Oh well, that's life.
I admire you. You're raising Audrey as a single mother.
What is it?
It's nice.
Why are some women luckier than I am? They have men who love them faithfully. How did they end up being so lucky? Why can't I find that?
It's her son's birthday, so what are you still doing there? Why don't you just come home? Victoria, you're not her nanny, and you're not even her father.
Please don't go home. Stay with me, Victor. Just stay with me.
I've been married for 10 years, and I've never cheated on my wife.
You know you can commit to 2 wives. You want to try it?
Is there something you need to tell me?
Are you doubting me?
Is there a reason to doubt
you?
No!